Have you ever received Excel data and it looks correct until you start getting into it? We're going to clean some Excel data using Power Query. And the issue we have in this specific file is we have two columns, column F and column G, that are cross-tabular, and they need to be put in a tabular format like column A through E, which is correct. I've already checked through a lot of this. There's no extra spaces. All the customer numbers are unique. There's no duplicate customer numbers. There's no duplicate records. First name and last name are broken out. They're not full name, as I've seen before. So everything looks good except column F and column G. Let me zoom in just a little bit. Here's the major issue with this data, and specifically those two columns. If you ask me to go and sort largest to smallest, and I go right click on F2 and do a sort largest to smallest, that is incorrect, because you can see I have 3,200 here and these other numbers running down column F. It only sorted by column F. Column G is not being included in the largest to smallest. The same thing applies if I go and filter and I want to see numbers over 1,000. I've already actually done this count if, so just so you don't have to see me do it again, there is the Excel function for count if. There's my data, F2 to F36. I should end up with 45. So if I go and turn on filter, control shift L, and again, I'm picking on column F, number filters greater than or equal to 1000. I hit okay. I got 12 records. I do not have 45, and that's what I should have. So we need to fix this data. Let me turn off those filters, control shift L, everything's back. I can make this a table myself, but using Power Query will convert this to a table. Just to show you where it stops down in G36. Go to the data tab under get and transform data group. You're going to hit from table range, picks up everything, and it says you got header rows, hit okay. Excellent so far. There's all my information sitting over here. Everything is good except 2024. I'm going to hold down the control key and I'm going to click on 2025. I have the two cross-tabular columns selected. I still should end up with two more columns. One is going to be called year and one I'm going to name purchases. So I'm going to right click and I'm going to unpivot these columns and watch what happens. It says attribute. I'm going to double click on that and call this year. And then over here for values, let's call that purchases. Perfect. And home tab, close and load. I'm going to hit close and load too. Does say table. I could make it a pivot table report. I can make it a pivot chart. I'm going to leave it as a table. I had a total of 35 records. Now when I hit OK, I should have 70 if my math is correct. Yes. So it goes down to 71. Here is my connection over here. You can close this if you want to. You don't have to. But now when I go and do my sorting by purchases, really simple, largest to smallest, it is correct. And then if I go and say, hey, I wanted to filter those numbers over 1,000. We had 45 a second ago, and we've got 45 now. I'm going to clear that filter. Also, our data is already in a tabular format. Great way to make a pivot table now. One thing I should have done, and I'm just catching this now, I should have left these customer numbers as text and not numbers. We can go back and fix that. Let me just do that. Go to the data tab. Queries and connections. Let's go and do an edit. Power Query is going to open up again. I didn't even catch that it did that. And I know it's number because it says 1, 2, 3 up here. I'm going to hit this drop down. Sorry, I'm going to right click it and I'm going to change the type to text. It's left aligned and it has ABC. Now let's just close again. It updates it. Now, when I highlight these truly are text. So I've got a count down here, and that's really what those customer numbers should be, text right there. There you go. That's part of cleaning data, fixing cross-tabular columns and making them tabular. Thank you for your time. My training is available online for Teams, Excel, Copilot, and OneNote. Thank you.